Deputy Mary Lou MacDonald. Thank you. Sorry, could I have a... I called Deputy MacDonald. Thank you. Would you please allow Deputy MacDonald to speak? Thank you.
Gurmagat Cian Corla. Tánaiste. Today the Troika complete their sixth review of the Irish so-called bailout programme. And I've no doubt that the government will be telling us that the main targets have been met, that the Troika are satisfied with progress as we approach the halfway point in the programme. No doubt you'll tell us that all is well and rosy in the garden. But Tánaiste, what progress are we really making? Yesterday, Finance Minister Noonan told the Finance Committee that growth projections will be yet again revised downward. Little wonder, given the wrecking ball this government have taken to the domestic economy. The total number of people, as you know, Tánaiste, on the dole queues are 434,800, or 14.3%. And there are 100,000 homes in mortgage distress. And Tánaiste, yet you, along with your friends in the Troika, plan to impose another 8 billion of cuts over the next 3 years. Maybe you can tell me, Tánaiste, whether or not the government have discussed the prospect of a second bailout with the Troika. Maybe you could also tell us whether or not you have discussed the issue of stimulus. You talk about jobs, you talk about it as being a way out of poverty. We accept that. Why is it, though, that you turn your face against stimulus?
Thank you. Tánaiste.
We don't turn our face against stimulus. This government is in favour of stimulus for the economy. And once again, Deputy MacDonald, you will find when the new memorandum of understanding is made available, and when the event takes place, and when the announcement is made about the outcome of the Troika review of our programme, you will find once again, Deputy MacDonald, that you are wrong. The Troika review will, as you have said, make it clear that progress has been made. I expect that the Troika review will directly address the issue of growth and the necessity for growth in the Irish economy. This government has always made it clear that in order to bring about recovery in this country, we do have to get our budget situation under control, we do have to get down the deficit, we do have to deal with the issue of the debt that we inherited and the enormous difficulties that we inherited from the previous government, but we have to get our economy to grow. And that means two things, Deputy MacDonald. It means, first of all, getting investment into this country. And you will have read, I'm sure, this morning, the article by the Chief Executive of the IDA, where he sets out the progress that the IDA has made in getting, over the last year, in getting additional jobs into this country. I will be joining, as soon as I leave here today, I will be joining him and the Taoiseach in my own constituency, at a plant where 100 new jobs will be announced, 350 additional jobs in construction, part of the evidence of the continuing attraction of jobs into this country. And he makes it clear in his article that in order for us to continue to do that, that we need to pass the stability treaty, something that you are opposed to. We also have to get growth in the domestic economy. And this government is very much focused on measures which are needed to grow our domestic economy, to stimulate it, to expand it, and to create the jobs that are necessary to bring about recovery. So you're going to be disappointed again, Deputy MacDonald, that the script that you have pre-written for yourself this morning will not be followed. There will actually, this review by the Troika will address the issue and the need for this economy to grow into the future.
Thank you. Deputy MacDonald, 1 minute. Thank you.
Well, you know, it'll be news to the hundreds of thousands of people on the dole queues that progress is being made. It certainly would be news to the lone parents upon whom you're imposing cutbacks that progress is being made, but you're sticking to your own script in that regard. You say that you're in favour of growth and yet you pursue a policy of austerity. I asked you a very direct question. I asked you whether or not, in your view, we are facing into a second bailout. I asked you whether or not you've discussed that matter with the Troika. I'd like you to answer that. And I'd also like you to clarify in this stall the fact that if this state is faced with this prospect, that we will have access to funding, irrespective of the vote of the people on your austerity treaty. I'd like you to clarify in the Dáil that it falls within your gift as government, exercising a veto, to ensure that no mechanism, no funding mechanism at a European level is designed in such a way as to block out Ireland. I want you to confirm that. You know as well as I
do
that the bailout fund can't come into existence without the ratification of this state. You know that, Tánaiste. However, in the absence of any positive argument for cutbacks and austerity, you choose to cynically scaremonger. So set the record straight in the House today and tell the people the full authority that you have on this matter. So are we looking at a second bailout? And reassure us, Tánaiste, that you will ensure that this state will have access to funding, because that is in your gift as well, you know.
You have a hard neck to ask me to set the record straight.
After yesterday.
You publish a leaflet quoting economists who support the treaty to give the impression that they're imposing it. Deputy.
Excuse me. Would you mind? Thank you.
Okay. Let me answer your question directly, Deputy MacDonald. Because your question is, have we discussed a second bailout with the Troika? The answer to that is no. We are pursuing.
Sorry, would you mind? Please, Deputy Toby.
Our intention, Deputy MacDonald, is to get out of the programme. And we plan to be out of the programme within 2 years. And we are on track to do that, and we're on target to do that. And I believe that the report from the Troika today will confirm that. And I am confident that we will do that. But there are things that can blow that off course, Deputy MacDonald. One of them, for example, would be if the people of Ireland takes your twisted advice and votes against the Stability Treaty. Because we need. No. Would you mind, please?
Thank you. Excuse me. Deputy MacDonald, would you mind asking your backbenchers to stay quiet, please? Thank you.
We can get out of this programme, Deputy MacDonald. Provided that there is continuing confidence in this country. We believe that confidence will continue in circumstances where the people of this country approve the Stability Treaty, ensure that there is stability around the euro, and assure investors that this is a good country in which to invest and to create jobs. On the other hand, if the people of Ireland follow your advice, for which you adduce in a twisted way the comments.
I really object to the personal insults that you're drawing across the floor. I object to it.
Please resume your seat. Would you resume your seat? Deputy, I'd ask you to respect the chair and resume your seat. Thank you. This is a political debate. It's not a peace. Thank you, Donald. You're way over time.
Councillor Corlett, I have not...
Sorry. Would you please? Thank you.
Councillor Corlett, I have never personally insulted anybody in this House. I do engage. No, I didn't refer to you. I did not refer to you as twisted. But the content of the leaflet that you produced is twisted. And the advice that you are now trying to sell to the Irish people, that somehow we can reject this treaty and that we'll have access to emergency funding if we need it, is twisted and it's misleading.
Thank you.